See, we need to do like advanced calculations.
So
then we might as well just pick up big balls. We can.
That is just back and forth, like actually how we're gonna have this elevator system work if we're not using bearings.
You're playing.
This is the max height, so we have to be able to have at least 3 linkages because 18 10 plus 18 is definitely not.
Really, not even equal. What?
So it's 2:40 on the day of the kickoff. Approaching 7 o'clock now. We're participating in Robot in 3 days.
Robot in 3 minutes.
Okay, this is the first test of the way. Hey! Yeah. So, Ian, your thoughts?
Overall, I think it works a lot better than I thought it would. I mean, we kind of threw it together, and the lift is really sketchy, and that's kind of the part I worked on. But it actually functions, so pretty happy with the design.
So we don't have an arena, so obviously we can't actually do any autonomous, but I think this year the autonomous part of the game is going to be really important, and it's kind of interesting how they set up the center goal and the IR beacon, that it's not just a drive and scan where it is, but it's actually in the center, so you have to circle around. That's interesting.
Unfortunately, we don't really have an arena, and we still haven't found that servo controller, and we left the router at Ian's house. So we're going to have to go off USB here, and our USB cable isn't very long. So I think this is actually going to be the worst demonstration of a robot in the entire history of First Tech Challenge, or any robotics event ever, but hope you like it. As you can see,
wait, how do I drive it?
Our power light is flashing as well.
That, and then
so
wait, linear slide, it goes up and down?
No, this thing, arm goes up and down.
And then what's on your side?
If you raise the arm right now, it's going to hit the counter, just so you know.
Sounds good. We're really good.
Okay.
My keyboard doesn't work. Okay.
Ready?
Should work.
Hey! Oh god, under the table.
Hang on, we got some more. Yeah, good enough. That
okay.
And now we toggle it.
Wait,
we don't have a servo controller, but this servo shuts. Also, we didn't tighten these screws.
And it's
not
wired, so...
Nah, it's okay.
That's good.
Whoa, geez, that was closer than it should have been.
And then we, unbolt the balls.
And lose them under the table.
And we can reach the highest goal, barely, but... the linear slide's not all the way up, but we can do it.
Okay, so that's our robot, folks. Hope you like it. This has been a lot of fun. Oh geez, don't do that.
1st?
How about, do we actually know where we're going, by the way?
No.
I know where...
No electronics here.
Anyway, shout out to Ziegler's Welding for this aluminum they donated. This is gonna be our drive base.
And then, yeah, we're gonna wanna have the motors replace.
We're gonna have encoders on the front, so... Do you want to do the Bay of Two Motors thing like we were going to originally do?
Yeah, I think so.
Please leave room for tracking wheels.
Well, you'll
have... Bay of Two Motors, like the thing where they're removable.
Oh, So, Ian, your prediction for how much our robot will weigh when it's finally done?
41.3 pounds.
My prediction?
Yeah.
2 pounds?
Our first competition isn't until November 22nd, so we're definitely still in the design phase here. One of the main tools we use for this is CAD.
CVT, interconnects.
No, Ian, this is supposed to be you doing CAD.
What does CAD stand for?
Ooh, we'll make this at an angle to look really cool.
Yeah. Why don't we do that?
What?
Have a tractor beam.
What? Honestly, having an arm that does that wouldn't be the worst.
I just drew that and you said, nah.
Except it actually, in hindsight, that actually would be the worst.
Yeah. So we don't have to be all the way. Because, I mean, our drive base is like.
It's true.
No,
it's
I really like the auto align function, though. Mm. That would be so cool.
Yeah, but at the same time, like.
Won't work.
Yeah.
It's true. So,
because if we drive our robot like kind of near the wall and we turn like that, we aren't going to be all the way.
I have a brilliant idea.
Oh boy.
It's for drive.
No.
So,
man.
Yeah. All the exciting things.
We want to get balls off of the wall.
Yeah.
We have a feeling that's the corner of the. This is the ramp.
Yeah.
And this is the wall.
Well.
And
yeah.
We have, or this is a corner, and there are balls in the corner, and we want to get them. And we can't drive like that.
Yeah, because then our pickup will be like here, and
yeah.
We'll be balls still.
And we don't really want to have to line right up next to the wall, because that's hard. So instead, we've decided to give up. Plus 64.
Math.
Is 208.
Yeah.
What's the square root of 208?
I don't know.
It's like probably 14.
A little more than 14.
Yeah.
So, that's too long. I mean, that says the 4-bar length, it has to be 14 inches.
Which I think is too long.
Well, yeah, because if the thing is 5 inches off the ground, I mean, that would mean it has to start at 14 inches from the ground and pivot right at the top.
Yeah.
And that's not really going to happen.
Yep.
Can we have something like going like this in the side?
That is a thought.
Yeah.
Wait, what? Ties on the side?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, well, we're probably gonna
like
have
a twister.
Well, I have a finger that goes like this. Not like this.
Yeah. How about like this?
I mean, we're gonna have a like mechanism flip out with these rollers, and we're thinking you have those brushes, but those
that's
can't
not
stick out
work
with.
Anyway.
Okay. For, other than for those reasons,
yeah.
They can't stick out beyond 18
yeah,
there
so
anyway.
Really
so really, we need something to pivot out that way.
Oh, with this strategy, though, we actually don't really. We could just have a. Okay.
We just don't want to deal with it right
now. Well, we'd have like.
Is it a horizontal vehicle thing?
Oh, this whole thing would rotate around.
Oh, that does require double gears.
And the differential.
Because
it will be rotating the opposite direction.
No, because if you have.
No, you're right. So wait.
Except for long. Wait, no, it won't even need to do that. We'll, like, get all this to the ground.
Maria!
Calm down!
Ah! What?
Oh my gosh. It is. There, yeah, do some filming.
Whoops.
Okay, so
18 boxes in your car?
Wait.
Got it. What is this?
Why am I the film camera person?
Okay.
These stickers.
Yeah,
oh,
yeah, we need
the
them.
Bottom roller.
I do.
You mean the feet?
Okay, I have the feet. So, let's each do one real quick. Oh, Levi, did you ask for your shield?
What?
Too late.
For letter of recommendation.
Oh,
yeah,
no, I have
one too.
Yeah, okay.
We should just ask him at once.
Yeah.
Be like, hey,
Andrew? Hey, Mr. Steele, come here.
And then put the feet on.
Is Mr. Steel leaving?
Yeah, he's leaving.
Derp.
Derp. Has he already left?
Oh wow, okay, this thing is actually kind of
cool. Oh yeah, Mr. Steel also mentioned that there's online, there's a like 3D model screen release mount thingy for the wires for the Samantha. Like there's a little thingy that has little clips for the wires.
Yeah,
there's
a.
Yeah, let's do it. What? Okay, now go.
It's good.
Well, so yeah, I have two things worth now, so.
Well, because you had one last year.
Okay.
No, you must have had two.
Well, I sort of had two. I mostly had.
And then
I
we have
13
now.
That's 13?
Yeah.
Now try tipping them.
Hey, how many are in each?
13, 8, and 4.
Interesting.
Wow, that tips really easily.
Yeah,
okay,
actually, they're pretty tippy.
Oh,
they're actually
going to be throwing people with that.
I guess the distinction is this. They do that really easily, but I don't think they'll fall over.
Well, try it. Do like 45 degrees. It's going to...
Wow.
John. Yeah, see, the fourth thing is completely right. My math was right. They do go in layers of four. My math is so good. So we can say around 70 to 80 small balls to fill the big one.
Ernest. So, Ian, you want to make a piece out of metal, let's just say part of a frame or something. What steps do you take?
Well, first we're going to design it all in CAD so we can get the exact dimensions. And then we'll take that CAD model and turn it into a 2D sketch, which we can then tape to a piece of, like, say, sheet metal. And then we'll probably use the bandsaw to cut out that piece by following the printed out sketch as kind of a template. And then we'll probably, once we've cut it out, file it down and drill any holes we need. Yeah.
I just realized we're walking the wrong direction. Like, Ernest isn't here.
Yeah, Ernest isn't here.
Did you bring your bike?
No.
Well, why are you going this way?
I don't know.
Approve. Let me just
put
that on
the
public record. I think this is a bad idea, and I do not endorse this plan.
Nor do I.
But I am wearing safety goggles, so what could go wrong?
Oh God, no.
Oh yeah.
Ian.
Wow. I forgot about that.
Is that screw, maybe?
Levi, why did we leave those?
We'll have to do it to this one.
Okay. We'll make a...
So these are
so the drill's just gonna drag on the ground.
Yeah, probably.
And I don't know. This right there and
there's gonna be really a lot of friction because it's gonna be drilling itself into the ground.
You know, importance of everything being exactly the same on either side. Completely useless.
Oh, bravo!
Our dry face is done.
Okay.
It's a shame, but it's no
game. Which way you going?
We know. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take this and this will be right here.
Which way you going?
There will be two threaded holes going
in there. We're doing all that we can.
Slowly sliding.
But some
my goodness, there are tables in the studio. Ian, what's the date?
Today is the first.
Of
October. Yeah.
October 1st?
Yeah.
Oh. That is it.
What? So Levi, what have you been doing recently?
I've been machining components a lot, but sadly the shop's closed today, so I'm working on the clamp mechanism right now. This is the beginning of
Looks like a C-clamp.
Yeah, this is gonna go into the inside of our robot, and pretty much the pentagonal base will match the curvature of this and hit at either two or three points, and then we'll have a roller that pulls it in.
I almost died walking into that rock.
But we have friction or something. It's going to prevent us from actually reaching our set point completely, because there's a force that's negating.
Okay.
Action hub.
Oh, we found one.
Oops.
So we're at 3,500
quick feet, yeah, whatever. And then I did the math and I got like it. They would do 50 out of 60 cubic feet in an hour, and then I was like, 1.2 is the only one that's even close.
Did you guys put aerodite or aradroid? I don't know how to pronounce it.
Aerodite or adroit?
Adroit.
Yeah.
Adroit is right?
Like, it says skillful.
Yeah, that's a droid.
Okay.
Literally not reading like smart. Right.
I missed that one, but I knew I was. Yeah.
Aerodyne means smart.
I was
like, not right. Was.
Oh, yeah, get some good punches in this drawing. That's about to take place.
Okay, now we'll just fire it up. Ian, what are you working on?
So we've decided to use our old lift on this robot, so I'm trying to mount this to that. If it runs out, I've got a camera. Oh. That wiffle ball.
Oh, jeez. Now I remember where it's here. That didn't get more straight up the middle.
Last time I was putting it like there.
I could have done better.
Okay, maybe this wasn't the greatest. That's one thing to know.
That's a problem. Oh, now that's close. That was not the best.
What? This is not working.
Hey! Okay.
Okay.
So, Ian, how many feet of chain do you think is going to be on this robot?
Well, the drive base probably has about 3 feet right now, and the lift is 4 feet tall, times like two, plus another couple feet. So, math.
Are the fuses hot?
I don't think these are fused. There we go.
Okay, raise? No, it just went in both directions. This one's wrong, okay.
This one's wrong?
Your wiring lies.
Okay, that's a flaw in the robot. So we're just heading off to H2O Jet. They're a pretty cool company here in Olympia that manufactures the H2O Jet machines. And they're also a pretty cool company because they like to help out local robotics teams. So we're gonna go and appeal to them for help with cutting our final robot.
Package from Servo City?
Yes, it is.
What's in it?
There are, I believe, there's...
Just look in the servo thing. Okay. Electronics. Brainstorming. Starts now.
Yeah.
I just put those in a random spot because I needed to get them somewhere. But,
I don't, honestly, that spot seems fine.
No, I agree. It just needs to be further.
We need,
three
more, don't we? Oh, wait.
Also, there's a question of where do we put the, everything else.
See, the problem with this? It isn't that they're not like in a good spot there, but then if I put them any further back, the string will hit them.
That's interesting.
Let me tell you, Mr. Brat, you are very hot.
I am hot.
distances.
Position that right.
What's that noise? Wow, that actually...
I think it's zip ties getting the thing.
Mr. Steinkamp is taking off his safety glasses.
The quarter scale server, I have this constrained so it actually rotates 1-4.
So here's how this is gonna go down. We spent the first 2 months of our season designing a robot in CAD. Then, we had 2 weeks to get it all cut out, got help from an excellent company called Mechanical Specialties. They were really nice about it, really helpful and great at what they do. So now we've got the parts cut out in aluminum. That leaves winter break to put our robot together, do the autonomous and make sure everything works before the Interleague Championship the week after we come back. Do you think we're gonna be able to finish this?
I'm a little worried. We haven't tested a lot of the components, but we'll see what happens.
So yeah, tell us a little bit about this upcoming meeting.
Well, it's going to start on the solstice and run through Tuesday. And we're basically going to camp out at Levi's house and work for 72 hours, I think. Or more. We might, like, just not want to leave.
Do you think the robot's going to get done?
Seeing as we don't have all the parts, yes.
Do you think the robot's gonna be good?
Describe to me what this meeting is gonna be like.
Lots of us eating food and building an entire robot in pretty much a day, hopefully. Oops. You wanna rip it?
Thank you.
about a concept of harmony and of music being correct. You can do whatever you want. So nobody told me what to do, and there was no preconception of what to do.
Raise up.
What? When it
does,
it dies.
It's still off.
Yeah, raise the lift up. We're gonna have to fix it.
The problem's pretty clear. We just need to fix the first.
Yeah, raise the lift up.
I can't raise it without turning it on.
That's fine.
Turning it on makes it click.
We know. Basically,
yeah, don't raise it any higher.
The thing is, I think it actually fixed itself right there. Because that clicking made the zero be here now.
Is this?
Which is actually right.
Now, turn it on. Yeah.
Oh, I lied. Just click it out a few times.
Now, do it across. Kind of pretty handy we can do that.
Probably really bad for servos. Shh.
Yeah.
Honestly, I think I figured this next position for the top one.
Yeah.
Whatever.
It'll start
go back down. It's the last day of winter break here in Olympia, Washington. As you can see, we're having excellent weather. With winter break almost concluded, that means we just have one last robotics thing to do over the break. And that, of course, is cleaning up. As you may be able to tell, we've been doing some robotics in Levi's room, and it's rather messy. We have some hummus here from
Trader Joe's.
Well, from a while ago. And over here, we've got, oh, grape juice. You know, I think this gets better when you leave it out, right? So we've made some progress, as you can see. We can now see the floor. If you're wondering if our robot is gonna work, I invite you to join the team. We have t-shirts. At this point, we really have no idea if it's gonna work out. You may be thinking, that's an awfully small drill bit for a drill press. In fact, it doesn't even fit. We're performing a very delicate operation here.
Oh, that one doesn't even fit either.
As you can see, that's a servo horn for quarter-scale servo. If you are an FTC person, look away now because we're doing something illegal. We're attempting to modify one of our servo horns so that it can work with a different model of servo. Moment of truth.
No, I need a small, large drill bit. Basically, I'm just trying to drill a hole that I can just jam that axle onto. That might have worked.
I don't actually know how to test this very well, but.
This is giving away lots of design secrets.
No.
Not this part, I guess. Oh, and not that part.
Feel free to look at that page, it's not helpful. That one, I guess if you're smart, it could help.
Good thing we don't have an intelligent users. Users, viewers. This is like all top secrets.
This part isn't. This is space elevator.
Yeah. Illegal for another reason. So are we inside 18?
Very close. Yeah, and there's a bolt head there. Yeah,
I think we're good. I think we're good.
Yeah.
Okay.
Actually, this
is
like a really good square. It's like
record.
Levi.
Yes.
Which batteries am I taking? Which chargers am I taking?
You are taking all the batteries and all the
chargers. Controllers? All of the everything.
Yeah, take everything.
Router? No, I don't.
Oh, router's right there.
There's an elephant right outside to carry it all for you.
Okay.
Is that the elephant in the outside the room?
It's actually super cool. Oh, good shot. Keep filming.
Oh.
Wait, camera's over there.
There we go. That actually looks super cool.
Yeah, can you just rotate it a little bit?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure. Oh, wait a second.
What?
I'm not sure the hopper isn't biased.
No, it isn't.
It's fine, because this is actually
I think level. We're using is too square level.
There's too much junk in my car for that thing. But really good cleaning up here, huh?
Yeah, I know, right?
Look, I just like made it a whole bunch of
extra. And an Allen wrench.
Look at all the stuff we can put in here.
Ian, what do you do? No.
Oh.
Go ahead.
Okay, that looks good.
Oh, man.
Yeah,
Press the red button. Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Can
you get a garbage truck out?
We don't have fixed balls. You're not a rep.
Next in our installment of getting things stuck under decks, Ian tried to roll the duct tape, and
I succeeded in rolling the duct tape. I might add.
Yes. Let's see if I can get a light on this thing.
And which? Yeah, that fixed.
Okay.
It's further that way. Can we just leave it till tomorrow morning?
Do we have another roll?
Yeah.
It's gonna be dark in the morning, though. Mm-hmm. It's gonna be 6:30. That's when I get up, and it's dark when
I don't need this roll.
Okay, let's just pretend like that never happened.
See, in a week? Here we go, we're gonna do, I'll just be like...
Night before the competition, Ian, is it gonna work?
Oh.
That's a small ball.
Oh, we got a small ball? Oh, interesting. Okay, whatever. We can deal with that.
Oh, that was 5.
Notebook is coming together just in time.
Oh, yeah.
That's Wilson High School outside.
Yay.
Woo-hoo. Hopefully that's Wilson High School.
It looks like Wilson High School.
Can anyone good. Read that?
I Google Mapsed it and it looks like that.
Continuation of Cascade.
Dick McNull's pool?
Same thing.
McNull?
Wait, water game?
What? Water game? No, can't really see. It's pretty foggy in here.
So something kind of cool this year. Previously, we've shared buses with other schools to get to the competition, but this year, this bus is only teams from our high school, and it is full.
Woo!
Yeah, but they have the same. Totally. No, they're different. There's just like one thread
wasn't in
his
thread. So that was where I dropped the robot.
Yeah, it's like
a
red
screw. Do you want something to cover that?
Do we have a cart?
Okay. Helicopter versus
No, honestly.
Ah, it's so fast.
That commentary.
Assembling the robot with a Sharpie.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just marking up the bolts so I can come to the right length. Problem is, some of these holes
aren't. Kind of a clumsy moment of truth, if I'm honest.
It doesn't hit.
No. This is what we call stupid stuff. So many hands.
This could be a great reveal show. So we got a package from IGUS today, and we're about to open it up. Important things happening before stage. Like Ian carrying this metal.
So is that it?
Yeah, just getting Ziggler's. Are we also gonna need to put laser
hat? Wait.
Okay, we have two robots. That one came down the ramp pretty doggone fast there in autonomous for Blue Alliance. 64-24, looking to score in that high goal here. In autonomous, watch it carefully. It's up, it's over, it's back. '64-24 gets up there ready to unload. Having a little trouble getting the balls out of their robot into the tube. And that's an issue with touching that tube.
One, go! Everyone making quick autonomous moves. Oly Cow lifting up and heading over towards those blue holes. He's making the section of the mid height. 71-93, the Cyber Ferrets have those balls. We're going to be lifting them up this corner of the goal. They look like they have four in that blue hole too. Oly Cow's looking high to drop in that blue hole. Ooh, undershooting a little bit, not quite making it. Having some gear catching ideas and pulling a two over, not fully over. And that is going down. Oly Cow's lining up towards that blue. Now that they've got a big Oly Cow is going to score, filling it up to the top. Mindbot Maniacs.
This is our alliance selection process. First up, before we get started, let's have one more big hand for all of our teams, please. They've all been great today. Looks like some last-minute advice from your stands going on. What's your name?
Oh, my name is Sydney Wallace.
Sydney, and what school are you from?
I'm from Union High School in Camas, Washington.
Union High School, very good. Are you ready?
Sure.
Sure, why not? Well, all you got to do is say four numbers. All right. The robots are all lined up here. You can go look at them if you need to help yourself. And whenever you're ready, let us know who you'd like to invite.
All right. Team 6559 graciously invites Team 6424, the Oly Cows, to our line.
Team 6424, the Oly Cows from Olympia, Washington.
Team 6424, do you accept?
Absolutely, graciously and professionally.
Congratulations! Go!
Got two robots moving here, and the third one moving, 3805, holding back in the parking zone. And Blue Alliance scores, coming down the ramp, grabs their crate, they're scoring, and heads for the parking zone. Kind of gets it part way in the parking zone. And that's the end of autonomous.
All right, drivers, pick up your controllers.
Your gift keeps on giving. What is this I'm feeling? If you want to leave, I'm with it. Too far.
Autonomous scores have been tallied. Driver control in 3, 2, 1, go!
All right, here in semifinal match 2 for these teams. They need some balls to make some scoring happen. 3805 succeeds in knocking down that kickstand, as does the Oly Cows. Now it's just a matter of making something out of it. Oly Cows are picking up balls. 28-56. Tesseract trying to get a hold of that high goal. Oly Cows proceed to score 5 balls in that high goal. Tesseract finally has a hold of it. No, they're still having trouble. Oly Cows moving in behind, pushing them off their high goal. And they finally get a couple in, or try to get it in. It misses a opening up there for them. Oly Cows getting another load. Up on top, and they load it up again. Another 5. Tesseract trying to get in and get balls, but Oly Cow is getting there ahead of them. They've got 4 more in. Tesseract has 3 now. Oly Cow's lining up. Now they're heading for the high goal in the center. It's almost time to start loading in there. Less than 30 seconds. And they've got 5 in, but they've got a little problem. And the Red Alliance, 3805, scores 4 in their goal. Oly Cows will get penalized for attaching themselves to that center goal. 28-55, trying to move around and get scored, and we're almost out of time. Oh! That was bad. And that's the end of the match 2 for this Alliance selection.
Hey everyone, you may not have seen us for a while. That's because we've got a lot of stuff happening. I guess the biggest piece of news is that we won the Inspire Award at the Washington State Championship, and we're going to Oakland. That's why we're fundraising right now. Before that, though, we also won the Inspire Award at the Interleague Championship, and we're going to state.
Yeah, this part was water jetted. Also, I'm assuming it's Waco Robotics, right?
She's gonna be really hard to test. Wait, did you glue it on?
Yeah.
You know, I think probably is the best way to do it.
Give up.
Glue. Yeah. No. Actually, that would work. Mm.
Yeah, I don't like
JB
that.
Weld.
No.
I
almost tried it and then I didn't.
The other option would be to have a piece of sheet metal on either side.
That's what I was thinking.
Big enough.
Like that, yeah.
And then just bolt it on top.
That's probably what we'll have to do. Say metal shavings in the motor controllers.
Jeez.
Hypothetically, this test is supposed to tell us something, but
I really should just go downstairs and get some wood.
So Oreo is broken. Oh, because they like playing.
We will be on an airplane in a bit.
Wait, a bit as in a month?
Yeah. A lot of teams have been asking us how we built our lift. And the answer is, don't build this lift, it sucks. Seriously, folks, we are currently in the process of replacing our lift to make our robot better. Now, it's true, we feel kind of bad about abandoning the thing we made ourselves and using something that's already kind of pre-built for us. But the fact of the matter is that this is going to work a whole lot better, and it's going to make our robot a whole lot better. I'll probably make a video about today's meeting.
Yeah. Also notice all...
They line up. Wait. To me, they look yellow and white.
These holes are too big.
No,
too.
It's blue and black.
A tab.
The rules.
For the thing. That's not 90.
6424 on our calipers. Now put a ball on it. Oh no, gravity doesn't work. Doesn't roll down. Oh, here, let's try it again. Try it again. Normally. Oh, that time it works.
Oh yeah. Wait.
It's not even. That's pretty bad.
We could play a game. Throw the cow hat on the robot.
Robot's real. These are upside down.
Like half of the plugs in the house are upside down.
It didn't even work very well.
It's alive! Oh.
That's zero. Sweet. Okay.
Very fast.
That's good.
Well, we file that down, use smaller sprockets. Probably have to do both of those.
Yeah.
Ian, where did we get these mouse pads here?
Oh, yeah, we were in Mr. Wright's room one day. And Mr. Wright wasn't in the room, so we just took some mouse pads, and they're going on the robot now. So can we blame you on the robot?
Like a solution is exciting.
I could get used to
agitated.
You mean an electron?
What?
You mean an electron?
No.
All right. That one worked.
Pick up.
So we have to pick up. Oh!
So, just what's that hole there for?
Because we have to have this servo door have a hole. I was thinking a rubber band there, actually. Run. Hey, we lived.
Get nommed.
Whoa,
exciting.
So what are you making?
What?
Ian, what are you doing to that block?
8 seconds.
Yes.
26,
53. What are you doing?
3, 2, 1. The world didn't end, okay.
I don't think.
Well. Eight pies.
And eating pie.
No!
Pretty much, like, these are all the colors. I really like the white, honestly. White and red. White.
So maybe we can have our competitions in the dark.
Yeah, but red and blue makes most sense.
Yeah.
And blue still looks pretty
good. Hey, Oh, yeah, that's cool.
Okay, reminiscent.
Yeah.
time. We'll know it's up to us to fix it. When it aches to make its mind, we'll pick it. Till then we'll steer it. Got a snare, we'll swim the distance. Fear after persistence, kin by cuts with all decisions. Live with, can't live without by now. That's why we shout so loud. Couple down, all respect allowed. The rest could never doubt. Options offered often. Toss them to the chop and block them. Hostile, dodge them. Keep watch what I've been rocking. Whole team got a grip, got it, no polish.
Doom tree, bang a ring. All these rappers sound the same. Beats sound the same. Raps sound the same. Wings fan the flames. Teeth with the fangs. 10 years in our lane. Doom tree, bang a ring.
Now underneath this canopy, crumbling insanity. Bellies rumbling, hungering for the fantasy. Had to see something come from them. Had to be crushing savagely. Not your average everyday. Nothing short of a master. And the tortures of the past are like a fortune for the future. We've been fortunate enough to know no borders, no rulers. No schools are out of session. No schools out of the question. No tools will go unused and no fools will go unmentioned. And there's a tension in the air we're breathing. We breathe heavy. We breathe largely. Release the levy, feel the tension in the air we're breathing. And breathe heavy, and breathe largely. Release the levy.
Doom tree, bang a ring. All these rappers sound the same. Beats sound the same. Raps sound the same. Wings fan the flames. Teeth with the fangs. 10 years in our lane. Doom tree, bang a ring. Doom tree, bang a ring. All these rappers sound the same. Beats sound the same. Raps sound the same. Wings fan the flames. Teeth with the fangs. 10 years in our lane. Doom tree, bang a ring.
Oh, they hate, they petty, they say we too heady, too heavy, too many, too much perk, much too drunk, too much luck, love too much, yup. But we earned it all work till the curtain calls and our time is up. They ain't got enough, and it burns them up. Before tour and first ad, it was D4, T-Rock, Tote Right, Big Shock, way more than a name drop. But I got y'all when I see y'all, then I keep y'all when the beat stops. I built more than a rap career. I got my family here, but some punks wanna jump up with a sharp tongue and they front something like we got here by dumb luck. But they just wanna become us. That's what's up when you come up. I move like a dump truck, too long in a road, and I earn what I hold. If you wanna let me know, I can burn your flow like whoa.
Doom tree, bang a ring. All these rappers sound the same. Beats sound the same. Raps sound the same. Wings fan the flame. Teeth with the fangs. 10 years in our lane. Doom tree, bang a ring. Doom tree, bang a ring. All these rappers sound the same. Beats sound the same. Raps sound the same. Wings fan the flame. Teeth with the fangs. 10 years in our lane. Doom tree, bang a ring.
Still in the debug setting. Okay.
Yeah.
So, taking the train to Oakland yet again.
Actually, subway.
Yes, we're taking the subway to Oakland.
We'll be doing that in Oakland.
So does the actual BART can't work like this though. This is just the shuttle.
No.
Because you can't have more than one
BART
train.
Is probably like, I don't know.
Okay.
Take the stairs in the hallway.
You good with this though, Levi?
Yeah, I got it.
Okay, film some stuff.
Alright.
Disaster averted. I mean, we may have forgotten something really important. But at least you weren't the first person to forget something on the trip. You know who that was?
Mr. Steinkamp, I heard.
Yep.
He pulled the old, I lost my wallet, can you guys buy me lunch trip?
Yeah, you owe me lunch.
That
reminds me, I lost my wallet,
can you open the door?
Oh, wait, no, he can't. Okay, Levi's gonna go print another one. We think we probably left it at the station.
Print it.
Did you check the menu?
No.
You had it last, Dan.
I...
Well, you had it in the airport.
Okay, so...
Should I sleeve my arm with
temporary tattoos.
Sure.
What do you need to do?
I need to do the banner.
Yeah,
okay, so you can do that. I guess I'll look over the presentation. Mm.
IR needs to be mounted better.
Oh. Why did it?
Yeah. It's Friday morning, and we've discovered the secret to infinite electricity. Yes. Eliminate the competition.
Pew, 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 pew.
I had to escape. The city was sticky and cruel. Maybe I should have called you first, but I was dying to get to you. I was dreaming while I drove the long straight road ahead. Could taste your sweet kisses, your arms open wide. This fever for you was just burning me up inside. I drove all night to get to you. Is that alright? I drove all night, crept in your room, woke you from your sleep to make love to you. Is that alright? I drove all night. What in this world keeps us from falling apart? No matter where I go, I hear the beating of our one heart. I think about you when the night is cold and dark. No one can move me the way that you do. Nothing erases this feeling between me and you. Oh, I drove all night to get to you. Is that all right? I drove all night, crept in your room, woke you from your sleep to make love to you.
You seen the robot?
What?
Have you seen the robot?
Only one plate of it.
Yeah, well.
Why, did you like get all the parts for you?
No, but there it's
Oh, it's not all the way taken apart.
No, it's not.
Yeah, you're doing something. It's not the right stuff.
I still
need to say something. It didn't work anyways.
Oh, Patrick, look at you.
Thanks, I'll provide us some around we need.
What are you doing?
Ready?
Yeah, okay. Cleaning out laser cutter?
Yeah. The video does not capture the smell.
Oh, nice. Oh my god.
Your thoughts on the season?
It was pretty great, except for the losing part. That was pretty bad, actually.
It didn't really lose, we just didn't win.
I mean, really, like...
Anything less than first place.
If looking back, it's pretty apparent that our goal was to build something epically awesome, and not necessarily to win.
Epically awesome
both.
It's just the...
awesome
well,
to win.
And also... Hypothetically, there are rewards for building epically awesome things.
Hey, Ian, you should put your finger in there.
That's like a great idea.
What was your favorite moment of the year?
That requires having like good moments.
I think mine was the one around the center of the hopper.
God damn, why don't you just sarcastic? Anyway, yeah. Your favorite moment?
This
we
moment.
All
no. Favorite
those
moment?
Were
magnetic.
I don't know,
ones.
During the game was pretty cool.
Yeah, testing the. I really liked brainstorming on the porch.
Yeah, that was fun.
And the weather was nice.
Yeah, that was always good.
That was just like our team, like right there. This is the notebook that actually had our plans in it, so it's like massive.
Yeah.
We decided to divide the notebook into different sections. First one's drive base. So this has all of our CAD and our drawings regarding the drive base. Planetary gearbox went in there. Next section was pickup. So we've got like, I don't know, 20 pages of us figuring out how wiffle balls work.
Oh, there you roll.
There's our most recent design. Yep. That's what we ended up using. The lift section is probably the coolest. We were originally going with a space elevator, which was just like a big pole that the hopper would run up and down.
I don't know why NASA are having so much trouble with it.
Yeah. So we've got a surprisingly large number of pages dedicated to that. And then we were like, that's a dumb idea. So this is what we ended up going with.
The Skyhook. Yeah, as it was never called, but...
Except right there.
Oh, yeah.
All lift stuff. Then we were like, our lift doesn't work, so then we switched to IGUS slides. And then it did work, which was nice.
So, yeah.
And then, yeah, we got Ernest talking about math.
Yeah, that could be autonomous. This notebook is why I was kind of bummed that we didn't get the Think Award. Kind of think we should have, but perhaps it was because this drawing is in pencil and you're not allowed to do that. There's just one more thing we have to do, Ian.
What is that?
I was editing the video last night and I found this video where we lose duct tape under the portable.
Yeah.
I think it was this portable.
Yeah, no, I don't know which. I mean, it was like pretty far back.
Well, I don't think we never find it.
Oh, wait a sec. Oh, look at that.
I guess we'll give this back to Mr. Brad.
This is the end of it. No more high school.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you,
Mr. Ray.
You guys.
Being a chill guy.
Thank you.
I feel so ready for college now. Mr. Ray is preparing.
We're
going
to come back.
Really?
Right now?
Not tomorrow.
Oh, no.
Mr. Ray has prepared me for college.
What's happening?
Story.
So excited, right?
All right.
Hey.
Wait.
I don't know if you guys know, but our entire team is seniors.
Yeah.
So, isn't really going to be next year.
And we passed school.
Yeah, I know. Considered flunking so we could keep trying, but...
That is all we have to say.
Ian, what are you doing?
So, this axle hub is stuck, but I need to move it down a little bit using a hacksaw brush.
Oh.